first tonight, many Queenslanders have sweltered through their hottest September day on record. And the scorching temperatures have both fire and health authorities on high alert. Sarah Greenholt has been in the heat for most of the day and she joins us now. And Sarah, how does it feel out there at the moment?
Well, Georgie, it certainly has been a scorcher in the southeast and inland today. It definitely doesn't feel like spring. It feels like we've jumped straight into summer. People packed onto beaches and pools right across the state in an effort to beat the heat.
No matter where you were, the aim was the same.
Spend a few hours down here and get out of the sun and get out of the heat, yeah. Cool down a bit.
Plenty of shade, mate, and yeah. Slip, slop, slap.
Both Gold and Sunshine Coast beaches were packed and the theme parks like Wet n Wild were even more popular. Getting in proved the biggest hurdle, but that didn't faze the kids enjoying school holidays.
It's just really fun on a hot day.
And how hot is it today?
Probably about 100 degrees.
While it didn't get that hot, authorities were still on high alert for cases of heat stroke and dehydration.
That could be nauseous, that could be vomiting, they could have diarrhoea, they'd be disorientated. They could also be, in extreme cases, unconscious.
It's a lesson these construction workers near Ipswich have already learnt after one of the boys collapsed on the job.
Yeah, he got a bit dizzy and he fainted and we had to do the right things and ring the ambulance and sort him out, but it was just a bit of heat stress.
Authorities are also urging people not to leave their children or their pets unattended in cars. In just 2 minutes, the temperature inside can reach up to 60 degrees.
Residents across the state should prepare for severe to extreme fire danger in the next 24 hours.
No good thinking about it when it happens. We want you to have a think about it now. Have a plan whether you're going to stay or whether you're going to leave if a fire does come.
We're expecting the cold front and trough that's due to sweep across southern Queensland during Thursday to kick up some dust areas out west, and it should also cause very elevated fire dangers here in the southeast.
Now, thankfully, the sun is beginning to set, although it is still feeling a little bit muggy outside. But the good news is we've got a reprieve on the way, Georgie.
That is good to hear. Thank you, Sarah.